Hello everybody, welcome again to another lecture of Learn with Vidhi. And in today's lecture we are going to see derivative of inverse function. So these are the basic formulas of standard inverse trigonometric function. The first one is sine inverse x. Formula is 1 upon root of 1 minus x square. So it's very easy to remember, because according to the substitution which we had done in the last lecture, 1 minus x square substitution was sine theta. So you can remember it that way. And this all formulas are just, will not do this first, we'll only do these three first. Okay, again for tan inverse x the formula is 1 upon 1 plus x square. Again same substitution was a square plus x square, and so 1 upon 1 plus x square, it becomes, the formula is 1 plus tan square theta is equal to sec square theta, or here it is 1 minus sine square theta is equal to cos square theta. Okay, and the third one is sec inverse x, the derivative is 1 upon x root of x square minus 1. So very simple. And what about this side? See, you can just see here for a second, you can understand, just you have to put a minus sign there. So for sine, whatever formula is there for sine inverse, just put a minus sign here, you get the answer for cos inverse. For tan inverse again, just put a minus sign, you get cot inverse. And for sec inverse, just put a minus sign and you get a cosec inverse. So that's simple. Okay, so let us start with the first sum. So first sum is very simple, y is equal to tan inverse x of log x. So first step will be, as usual, differentiate with respect to x. And now what to do? Again the same very simple sum, just give d by dx on both the side. What we are going to do, put d by dx on both the side, dy by dx equal to d by dx of tan inverse x, tan inverse log of x. Now next step, now what we are going to do, see here, we have a standard formula for tan inverse x, which is 1 plus x square, but we don't have a standard formula for tan inverse of log x. So what to do? So just don't think about this, kuch bhi nahi hai yahan pe, aise socho. यहाँ पे समझो x है, फिर कुछ भी नहीं, तो x है यहाँ पे, तो व्हाट इट विल बी, 1 अपॉन 1 प्लस x स्क्वायर. सो इन प्लेस ऑफ दिस इट वाज x, राइट, बट हियर वी डोंट हैव x, वी हैव समथिंग एल्स. सो यू हैव टू जस्ट पुट व्हाट एवर इज देयर इन द ब्रैकेट ओवर हियर. दिस इज समथिंग व्हिच इज चेन रूल, यू मस्ट बी नोइंग दिस, बट अगेन आई एम गिविंग द एक्सप्लेनेशन फॉर इट. टैन इनवर्स x फॉर्मूला इज 1 अपॉन 1 प्लस x स्क्वायर, बट इन प्लेस ऑफ x यू हैव समथिंग एल्स, सो यू हैव टू पुट दैट समथिंग एल्स ओवर हियर. ओके, very good, but as we know that we have a standard formula for x, we don't have a standard formula for tan inverse of log x. So I have to take whatever I have kept under this green color, I have to take its derivative again, and so I am taking its derivative over here. If it was only tan inverse x, my answer would be 1 upon 1 plus x square, but as it was log x over here, I simply put it over here as 1 upon 1 plus x square, and I have taken the derivative of it. उसके आगे है मल्टीप्लाई बाय डी बाय डी एक्स ऑफ लॉग एक्स कर दिया, राइट, बिकॉज इट्स चेन रूल, राइट. आई एम ओपनिंग दोज बॉक्सेस, पहले बॉक्स के बाद में आई एम गोइंग टू अदर सेकेंड बॉक्स. ओके गुड, नेक्स्ट, नाउ नेक्स्ट विल बी व्हाट द आंसर, what we have done, dy by dx comes as it is. Even if you don't write in middle step, dy by dx is fine, but at the last step you have to write it, 1 upon 1 plus log x the whole square, it has come as it is. And what is derivative of log x, it is standard, so it is 1 upon x. So this is your answer, this is the answer for the given question, that is y is equal to tan inverse of log x. Let us do the next sum. Next sum is y is equal to sine inverse root of 1 plus x square upon 2. So we'll first write differentiate with respect to x. Next step, just take dy by dx on left hand side, and that is, you have to take d by dx on both the side. Now what? Now the first step is what? See here, what is derivative again of sine inverse x? Just don't think whatever. Yeah, here sirf x aise samjho. So sine inverse x derivative is 1 upon root of 1 minus x square. So whatever is there inside that bracket, you have to just put it as it is. But again, we know that instead of here it should be x for standard, but here we don't have x. So we have to take its derivative again, and so I have taken the derivative of the bracket here. Understood? Sine inverse x derivative is 1 upon root of 1 minus x square, but in place of x you have something else, whatever is there in the bracket you have to put here in the place of x, and then you have to take, if there it is not x there, then you have to take its derivative again. Okay, next step, now what? Now I have written this is as it is, it is going to come as it is here, multiplied by, what is derivative of root x? Derivative of root x is 1 upon 2 root x. Again, this is x, For example, what is the derivative of root x? 1 upon 2 root x. So I have taken as it is. Whatever is there, you have to write as it is. And as it is not a standard formula, you have to take its derivative again. Whatever was there inside, you have to take the derivative of that here. Then derivative of 1 plus x square upon 2. Now next step. This is the last step. What I have done, I have taken this as it is. It is as it is here. This is also as it is here. What makes difference is this. Just see half. How this can be written? Half plus x square upon 2. What is derivative of half? It's 0. What is derivative of 2 x square? X square derivative is 2x upon 2. 2x upon 2. So 2 and 2 gets cancelled and what remains is only x. So the x I have written it directly over here. It is x. Understood? Half plus x square upon 2 it was. So half is 0. Derivative of constant is 0. And x square derivative is 2x upon 2. 2 gets cancelled. Answer is x. And so this is your final answer. Let us see one more example. Y is equal to cosec inverse 1 upon cos 5 raised to x it is. Differentiate with respect to x first step. Second step is as usual. Put d by dx on both the side. Okay, now what is the next step? So next step is what? This is very important step. See here what I have done. I have done a very beautiful thing. See, cosec inverse x is what? 1 upon x, okay? So I have changed cosec inverse to sine inverse. See what I am saying. See it again. Cosec inverse is written as sine inverse and 1 upon x becomes x. Okay. This you can do for tan. This you can do for cot. So what is the formula? Cosec inverse of 1 upon x is equal to sine inverse x. Again, I am telling cosec inverse 1 upon x is sine inverse x. For tan inverse, same. Tan inverse 1 upon x is cot inverse x. Sec inverse 1 upon x is cos inverse x. Yes, getting it? So in place of cosec, I have written sine inverse and 1 upon x becomes x. So this is very important. Just remember, this is a very important formula. We have 3 formulas. We have in all 6 formulas. You can also take it as sine inverse 1 upon x is cosec inverse x. It also goes the other way around. Okay, so this is very important. So next step. Now what I am doing, I am making the derivative of sine inverse x. So what is the derivative of sine inverse x? Again, I don't know whatever be there in the bracket. I don't want to see it even. So sine inverse x, what is the derivative of sine inverse x? 1 upon root of 1 minus x square, whatever was there in the bracket, I have just put it over here. Whatever be there. As it was not x, it was something else than x, it was not standard, then its derivative has to be taken. So I have taken the derivative of cos 5 raised to x. Now next step. Again, I have written as it is. This comes as it is. No change in it. What is now again derivative of? I don't have derivative of cos 5 raised to x. I have derivative of cos x. Right? So, what is the derivative of cos x? Very simple. Cos is minus sine x. So, I have again whatever was there inside this bracket, I have taken as it is. But as it was not x, it was something else. So, I have taken again derivative of that thing, whatever is it is, 5 raised to x. You're getting it. You're just opening those boxes. We have box. Pehle bada wala box uthao, fir uske baad andar ka box usko kholo. It goes that way. Okay. Now the last one. Last step is what? This comes as it is. It is not going to change. This is not going to change. Now what is the derivative of 5 raised to x? This is a constant because a raised to x is a standard function and standard derivative is a raised to x log x. And I have written the answer over here. Okay. So this was something very beautiful. And just remember this what I have told. Different formula we have taken over here. Okay. So thank you for watching and do like the videos, share this videos and don't forget to subscribe to my channel. Thank you. Stay home, stay safe.